Hello. So I want to introduce an exercise today that I think is really important for beginning to understand the footwork and the movement mechanics of the Wong style Tai Chi form. Now, before you begin this exercise, it is well advised that you spend some time trying to understand where your vertical center is, your vertical axis. I personally feel the best way of doing that is by standing in like a wuji posture, like a jangzhuan. You don't have to do it a lot. You just have to do it enough to understand where your center is falling through your body and how all your limbs relate. So you have to understand the pressures on the bottom of your feet, understand the ankles, the knees, the quad, the pelvis, the low back, the chest, shoulders, head, and neck. Understand how all of those relate to maintain the center. So once you can understand the center to a some degree or feel it a little bit, then it makes it a lot easier to do this exercise. Okay, so it's advised to spend some time doing that. So once you have kind of an idea of where your center is, then it's a pretty simple exercise actually. So I'll show you how to get into it. I've broken it down into about 8 steps. The first is to spend time finding your center. That's number one. Number two is getting into the position, starting for the wuxing bu exercise. And how you do that is by adopting a shoulder width distance stance. So not too far out, not too narrow. You just want a little bit more than hips distance apart. Okay. And kind of find out what works for you. If it's too narrow, the balance is going to be an issue. If it's too wide, your energy is really split too far out to the side. So you just want something where you can be nice and relaxed and everything dropping down. Okay. So once you've found the shoulder width distance, you're going to turn 1 foot out. In this case, it's my right foot, about 45 degrees. The left foot is going to move forward as if it's on a ski or on a track. And you just want to make sure that you're moving it far enough that you're clearing the toes on the right side. Some common errors for people when they shift out and step, they might step in or they'll overcompensate and they'll step out. So you don't want to do that. You just want to step straight forward. It's not uncommon. The most common one is actually to step in narrow. So if you get some tightness in your hip, or you're not used to making that position, you're gonna come in. So just really pay attention to this when you're starting out because you do want to maintain this foot position. Okay. Step one, find the center. Step two, get into the position. Okay. Now, this exercise begins in what we call a 50-50 position. So don't think double weight, think where the center is balanced. So the center for me is balanced for my body shape and proportion, roughly somewhere between my feet. I'm getting some information on where that exists because I spent so much time working on finding my center in a standing position and also understanding pressures on my feet so that can help you get a little bit closer to this position. So for beginners starting out, tune into where your feet are. The pressure can be on your heel, can be on the ball of foot, or can be on your toes. We want the pressures roughly on the ball of the foot, not on the heel, at least for this position, and then not on the toes. So ball of the foot, and you want it ball of the foot on the left and the ball of the foot on the right. So you're just getting a sense of, is there equal heaviness there? And then how does the movement of my center or shifting relaxation can sometimes do it if I get things into better position, how does that keep those pressures roughly even? And then getting a sense of where your center is in that position. So once I'm fairly confident I'm 50-50, then I'm going to make sure that my hips are square, they're facing forward, and they're not rotated up. See, I'm not over rotated this way, I'm not over rotated this way, I'm just square. Okay, so T quad, like scoring the quad, simply for right now. Okay, so that's step three. Step one, Wuji, find your center. Step two, get in the position. Step three, find 50-50. And step four, I think it's helpful to just start turning in a 50-50 position. So I'm turning my center left and I'm turning it right. And what I'm trying to do here is get a sense of movement from the quad. Okay, so the quad is kind of this inguinal crease. If I sit down in a chair, it's like folding into my lap. It's this crease right here. So this is where we want the movement to happen from. So everything's relaxed and moving from here. Also with turning, I can get a sense of how well connected my legs are. So if I'm turning and my knee goes out, then I'm too, generally speaking, I'm a little too stiff. One direction, if I turn going this way, my knee pulls in, stiff in another direction. So I have to be able to turn the quad, fold, unfold, and just let this knee float. I want the connection to go travel through the knee. I don't want to go to the knee. So the pressure of the ball in my foot's unchanged, staying the same. Turning. And that's for both legs. So I'm 50-50. This back leg is not rotating in either. If I go too far, and then I can't open this enough and my knee goes in, so then I just want to be sure that I'm turning my center in a distance that allows me to maintain these connections and principles. It's okay if the knee travels forward slightly. You don't want it to go in or out excessively. So as I'm turning like this, there shouldn't be a whole lot happening with the pressures on the bottom of my foot. Not a whole lot anyway. There's a little bit, but for the beginner, you just want to make sure that you're not shifting too much on the outside of the foot or shifting too much on the inside of the foot or back into the toes or under the heels. You just want to keep that one point soft and connected and relaxed in the ground. So that's step four, okay? Step five is understanding moving to 100-0. So in this case, the center is moving 100% into one limb, okay? So you're gonna turn, and then you're gonna start to shift your center, connect, relax through the quad, so that 100% of your center and all of your balance is on one side, okay? Still pressures on the ball of my foot. If I pick up my foot, I shouldn't shift or change. So I have my balance. I'm pretty relaxed. I'm connected through the quad. My toes are just kind of floating here. Okay. So turn. Shift the center. Relaxing through the quad. Connecting to the bottom of the foot. Now I have my balance. Okay. So this foot comes up. I can relax my foot and still have some weight on this side, just the weight of the dead limb, but my balance and my center is right here. So this is 100-0. So the next step, step six, I'm gonna turn and then step out. So as I turn, again, my knee's not going in, turn, open the quad, this pivots his toe. I'm gonna take and switch from the toe back to the heel. Okay, and then just relax my foot. My center is still here. My relaxed leg, the weight of the leg is kind of connected to this foot. So, but it's just the weight of the leg. My center is still here. Okay. You have to make sure that when you're turning, stepping, you're not stepping out too far. And again, same thing, you're not stepping into too narrow, and you're not stepping too short. It takes a little while, and that's the nice thing about this exercise is it really helps you understand where your feet are relative to the rest of your body. So after repeating and practicing this multiple times over and over, your brain will know exactly where your feet are, and you will automatically go into these positions. You won't have to think about it. That's why it's such a good exercise to practice in the form, because when you're moving around and you add your hands, you don't want to be looking down and thinking about where you're putting your feet. So this gives you a good idea of where they are and an ability to practice it in a relatively easy way. Okay. All right, so foot's relaxed. Now, number seven, we're going to pivot, turn the center and pivot the back heel. So this is the back heel because it's the back leg. So the center is all here. My center currently is in the ball of the foot, and I need to get my center, the center line pressure to the heel. Because if I try to turn and pivot with the center connected to the ball of the foot, I'm just twisting my knee, and you don't want that. But if I shift a little bit, so like I bring my center and the center pressure connection to the heel, one, my foot will lift up a little bit, and it allows me to then continue to turn and just pivot around that heel. Once I'm done pivoting, then I just reconnect the center to the ball of the foot, complete the turn. Okay? So that one's really important, 100% here. Relax here. Shifting the center, the pressure to the heel. Turn, pivot the back heel. And then I got to bring the center back to the ball of the foot. Notice there's not a lot of external movement here. My center is still back on this leg. This leg does have something through it that kind of allows it to make the pivot over, but my center is here. Okay, the weight's not going this way, and the weight is not just all here, but the center is here. All right, so step eight, the last part after I've turned, is to then shift to 50-50. Okay, so it's kind of what we did to start out. Turn, step here, get into that 50-50. So you're going to try to feel the pressures and where the center is balanced between the 2 feet. Pivot the back heel, turn, connect. Now I'm going to shift slightly until I feel that I've got this 50-50 position. And my hips are square facing forward. And just relax. And that's it, that's one side. So then you're just going to reverse it for the other. There is really just 5 steps. Kind of makes it handy. Wooshing boo, 5-element step. So you're going to turn, one, two, shift the center, three, step the heel, four, pivot. Turn the center, pivot the back heel. Five, shift back to 50-50. One, two, three, four, and you can just repeat, 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 repeat. Trying to stay as relaxed and connected, sung throughout the whole thing. As much as possible. You try not to collapse. You want to keep the structure but relax all the muscles through. It gives you a great, and as you start to move, it helps you further define where your center is and be able to pay attention to how it's moving and how it shifts when the rest of your body is moving around as well. Okay.